So that will be Cronwall with Smith taking on Crosby and company. Here's Alfredson, Franz it in and sent one high. Pascal Dupuis out for the year for the Pittsburgh Penguins, so they wanted someone else on Crosby's side. Here he comes. Crosby with a backhander. There to recover with Sheahan as the Red Wings look to regroup in tight quarters. Losing to Tarr. And a save made off Joel Vitale by Howard. In the first meeting in December here at Joe Louis Arena. Neal shoots one and Howard will hold on to that. Neal with a shot. Hit a body in front. Crosby went looking for it. It was slapped past him. Good move, Malkin. His shot got blocked. And another try there by Crosby as Howard came out. Landon Ferraro and Corey Emerton are out there for the Red Wings to try and kill this off. Tipped by Crosby. And Howard came up big there again. Fleury ducking deep into the net. Not sure where that was going to come off. He obviously saw Jonathan Quick here early in the season. You never know, it might hit your back and go in. A race for that loose puck. And Denning's away, all alone, saved by Fleury. Oh, Luke Glendening in a bid for his first National Hockey League goal. How huge would that have been in more ways than one? That shot's blocked off the stick of Olli Maatta. Dozen seconds to go in the power play. Mata's shot stopped by Howard.
Both number 71 and number 87 spent the whole 2 minutes on the power play. And here was Glendening. Shoot the puck, kid. Never mind Deacon. Try to put it through him if you can't put it around him. And there was a little bit of a break for Glendening. No penalty against Crosby. He's looking for one for sure.
Good move, Franzen. Another backhander, second opportunity in on Fleury. DeKeyser with a shot. That was blocked by Orpik in front. Alfredson got knocked down. Fans wanted a penalty, none coming. As you see, nope, Jokinen got the puck out to center.
Red Wings have switched the defensive pairing up already. They got DeKeyser now with Cronwall and put Smith with Kindle.
I mean, pick your poison.
Yeah, right.
Which will put Lashoff with Quincy. Ah. Scores!
What a ball.
Alfredson, roof shot!
Well, we thought that Alfredson might catch fire after his goal the other night, and only a veteran presence with patience is going to make this play. Watch Alfredson coming in here. Hold it right there, guys. He's going to shoot there, and he says no. The key is driving the net, two guys occupied. He's going to bring it in, come to the right, and then drill it into the top corner over the catching glove. Very good patience by Daniel Alfredson. He's moving. That changes the angle to the net. And he gets another one to make it 1-0 Detroit.
Halkkonen left it there. Look for the return pass. He's got it now. Gives it to Franzen. There's a shot to save. The rebound. Franzen knocked it out of the air, but with a high stick, they say.
Hit the ref.
Marcel Gotch is waiting for the puck to come to him. It never did. Ooh, a hard hit there. As Landon Ferraro, number 29, went down. Drove the 401 to come back and watch his son play here again tonight. So he's in the seats at the Joe. Part of another sellout crowd. Passed in front of the net. Mental part out, and that's maybe the toughest part. Shot in by Cronwall, gets blocked, and it's Crosby who's trying to break free. Played it past Brendan Smith, who's there to knock it away.
Saturday, and then Sunday night for game two. Home and home with the
penalty coming.
Team. Hit from the side.
Boarding the call. Cronwall gives it to Franzen. Red Wings power play 18th. Penguins penalty killing second. Thrown in front by Franzen, and Bertuzzi just couldn't get a stick on it. Bertuzzi knocked down Scuderi into the boards. Good save there off Alfredson by Fleury. Bertuzzi stops inside the line, pushed it back to the point. Cronwall here to Alfredson. Pass it off. Nyquist in front. Hey. Score!
It could be Nyquist's goal. I think Scuderi deflected it in. Power play goal, minute 12 left. And it's 2-0. There's Scuderi, got knocked down. Oh, yeah. Scuderi got knocked down by Franzen, and they may have gotten away with one there. Cross-check from behind, and Scuderi does the rest, and he's going to the referee right away about you can't allow that to happen. 2-0 Detroit, and Nyquist remains red hot.
Nyquist has himself a 20th goal, a 20-goal season for Gus Nyquist, and his 15th since January 20th, best in the National Hockey League for Gus Nyquist, number one in the league in that time, in the past 2 months.
Big shift now for Detroit, 2-0 lead, follow-up shift important. Malkin's out there.
Detroit
Bell tire power play by the Red Wings. A shot right ahead to Glendening, not called.
Guess who? Yeah.
Here's Ferraro. Looks in front of the net. With Miller driving the goal, there's going to be a penalty now.
What did I say when we started this game? It might be Crosby, it might be Malkin, but it's Neil who got really, really upset and had a vicious cross check to Glendening's head.
Kunitz skate turned over, back into a hard jolt at the line on Miller by Bortuzzo. Crosby to Kunitz. Smith all over Kunitz.
Good checking again.
And then interfered with Smith on the way back by Kunitz. There's a penalty coming, but it's going to be to whom?
Well, we're all mixed up again.
Tom Cowell making the call, albeit delayed. Let's see who it is against.
It should be against Kunitz.
Should be. Nyquist, who's got his 20th goal of the season for Franzen. Moved it through. Cronwall down low. Nyquist slot. Alfredsson. Save made.
It's a huge save by Fleury right there, boy.
Regaining control of it, though, was Franzen, who left it there for Tatar. Penalty upcoming. Interference to Bertuzzi.
He doesn't like it, but...
Shot by Smith, stopped by Fleury. Oh, and
behind him.
Leg one, nearly. Nearly.
Oh, look at that cross-checking. Holy jump. What is
and
going on here?
From center ice.
They got to blow that whistle.
Penalty. There is.
Good Lord.
Cross-check called on Jokinen.
What are these guys thinking about? How you're not going to get a penalty?
So we got a 4-on-3 power play when we come back.
Cross-check.
Wow.
With Jokinen in there with Kunitz. Red Wing, man advantage. Looking to go up by three. Crosby carries in. Points in 51 of the 68 games in which Crosby has played this season. He's got the puck now, moved it quickly, back to Malkin. Smith tried to get to it, just missed it.
Find your guy.
Malkin shooting, look how far out Jimmy Howard was to make that save. As the teams are four aside for another 5 seconds, and then Bertuzzi comes out of the box, and then the Red Wings will go to another power play in which they're on right now. Cronwall and Leguan in reaching for it. Kunitz got it again. Batted away by Miller. Chris Kunitz took the shot to the goal. They score! Wow. Change direction in front. They made something out of what was nothing.
Well, I think it might have been Stempniak that redirected the puck. They sure did. There were three guys high on the Pittsburgh three and two on two in front of the net.
It's Stepniak.
There's the redirection right there. He got good position if you're thinking of the points. Not good position if the puck gets back. And that baby had eyes. And Stepniak does get the goal.
Boy, Crosby must have been complaining about the interference because he for 10 seconds after that goal, he was talking to the referee.
Yeah.
But that's the battle in front of the net.
Yeah.
Kaiser's doing.
Might have got his stick up a little bit on Crosby. That's a huge goal for the Pittsburgh Penguins here.
Playoffs and the regionals and... upset in overtime, Penn State.
Oh,
off the side. Great chance. Howard came over. Neil says it's in.
It's in.
Malkin says it's in.
It is
in. And the Penguins have tied the game.
Boy.
Again, something out of nothing. Just off the faceoff. That quickly.
Well, Neil hit the outside of the post. Right there, outside of the net. How does this puck end up in the net? Malkin? Yeah. Oh, boy.
Off Howard and in.
Well, just like the goal Detroit scored, the second goal. Detroit scored a goal on themselves like Pittsburgh did.
And again, 4-1 winners first time in here.
It's going downhill fast in a handbasket. Tatar's going to go probably for a hook here now. Detroit's had their chances on their power play.
Kunitz with Neal and Crosby and Niskanen and Malkin. There it is in front. What a stop! Great save on Neal by Jimmy Howard. Midweek. Taken by Ferraro.
Oh, no.
But over the glass.
Oh, boy.
And out of play.
Oy.
Off the draw, Malkin. Howard came out. So 5-on-3 for the second best power play in the league, and it scores. Malkin drives it home, and it's 3-2.
Hmm. 10 seconds it took. I don't know what Malkin saw from out there in a 5-on-3. I thought, geez, he's not going to shoot that, is he? But he let a rocket go, and it was right in the top corner.
He kept the puck for his 20th goal of the year.
Oh,
or his 21st, the second of the game.
I see why he shot the puck. Now he's got Kunitz and a Red Wing defenseman. Watch this. Hold it there, guys. Look at this. And here's where he's going, right up there.
Where he's going.
Yeah, exactly.
So he's got two tonight. That's his 21st.
Yeah, Howard never saw it.
And it's a 3-2 lead, late stages, period two. Coming back from that 2-0 deficit. Crosby to Neal. Save Howard. Rebound Kunitz. Neal turning with it, sent it wide. From the point comes Lashaw. Kindle moves up on Adams, who makes the play, and all alone is Sutter. From the blue line in, and Howard got a piece of that. And over top of the goal. Big stop. 3 minutes into the third period to keep this just a one-goal Penguin lead. The Penguins and those highly skilled groups, they know how to use the boards here at Joe Louis Arena. Good stand-up hit by Smith. What a jolt on Kunitz.
He took it pretty good, though. And they need one badly here.
Their fifth Beltire power play of the game. Hulkanen with a shot. Shane on the rebound. As Howard will come out. Good save. Another one. So power play for Pittsburgh. Crosby to Matt Niskanen.
Oh boy, who's without a stick? Glendening.
As Miller forced Malkin. So down a man and down a stick.
Now Malkin
shoots it away.
Oh boy. Now, is that a penalty? The question is the stick broken? Malkin shoved the stick away towards the board.
This is 18 interference.
That's a very interesting call.
No kidding.
Well, it must not have been broken.
Well, that's what I mean. I thought it was broken at first because it was in his feet. Now
well,
watch
it was
this.
Sent back to him, so it must not have been.
Right there. I thought he was going to reach down and grab it, but he wasn't looking. There's Neal, not Malkin. I'm sorry, I misspoke.
See how he looks back right here, Mick.
Yeah,
he's like he's going to bend down to get doesn't. So that's the right call.
Yeah. Very interesting. And Biles was still kind of bewildered about why they called that.
Red Wings 1-for-5 in the power play tonight. Pittsburgh 1-for-4. Approaching the halfway point in the third.
Look at this. Penguins fall down.
Here's Sheahan with Tatar. There's the pass.
Yes.
There's the goal. Tatar. Tie game.
Well, you don't see many goals like this anymore. 200 feet. Tatar on 4-on-4. Here he comes from his own zone. Now watch the defenseman. Right there's the key. They collide, and down they go. That means the puck's open to the wide side to Sheahan, and then Tatar, head down, heading for the races, and he flips it up over Fleury into the top corner to tie the game at 3. 4-on-4 goal. And the animated Thomas Tatar hot sauce does it again.
Talk about sauce. What a saucer pass,
yeah,
by Sheahan.
What a pass. Bad break for the Pittsburgh defenseman. Their feet collided. Down they went, but good effort by the kids. And we're tied again.
Glendening with stick in hand, dumped it in. Then ties up Mata. Miller pressured, forced the turnover. Bertuzzi to the front of the net.
Oh!
They score! Todd Bertuzzi! It's 4-3!
Boy, oh boy. What a night for bounces. This is the second goal that's bounced in off a Penguin defenseman. The puck was given away because of the pressure. Bertuzzi got it, went to the front of the net with it. I don't know if this hit Glendening or not, but if it did, it'll be his goal. It went off the defenseman for sure, right there. Now twice, Pittsburgh has put one in their own net. Wow, and Detroit once. Wow. 2 minutes, 18 seconds. Back-to-back goals by Detroit. It'll be Bertuzzi or Glendening. Wow. What a turnabout that is.
You couldn't have written a script for this game.
No kidding. Well, I'm going to say that Detroit needs 18 points of their last 28, no matter how they get them, whether they get ties or not, to get them 93 to get into playoffs.
Glendening with the opportunity as Bertuzzi's got his ninth. Red Wings scored two straight, then Pittsburgh with three. Bertuzzi a lift of the stick. And now the Red Wings with the last two. A miscue there by Stepniak.
Listen to this building. You'd think this was a playoff game. Detroit needs to be very careful now with 7 minutes to go. They got to play man-to-man, and you got to make sure you got your guy covered and don't get caught on the ice too tired. Well, that's when you make mistakes.
The building on Tuesday night was as loud as it could have been with Toronto in town, and now tonight coming close to it, and the majority here tonight are Red Wings supporters. They come to jeer Crosby, not cheer.
I got Jokinen's at it again, fiddling around with Quincy, and Smith is there. He's giving a stick to Malkin. Boys are getting a little bit ugly out there. Give them all a cookie and make them settle down. That might do it.
As long as it's gluten-free.
They're funny cookies anyway.
They're all about the cookies. Tatar and Bertuzzi. Up comes Gibbons. He went heavily into the boards. Glendening there. They center front. They score. Tie game, Adams. Left all alone. Just his fourth goal. Penguin bench up and happy. It's all even again.
These are these board battles that the Red Wings don't win enough of lately. They've had the puck end up in the back of the net too many times. Beautiful little pass right there by Sutter. It was Sutter that knocked, I think, Kindle down and knocked him off stride, and then nobody covers in front of the net. Lashoff goes around instead of, you got both defensemen behind the net, and that doesn't work.
Shane kicking at it. Tatar got it through to Nyquist. Nyquist the front of the goal. Tatar trying to stay with it. Oh, Cronwall. He was searching. He was on a seek and destroy.
He'll be buzzing that night again. Seven games in 11 days, and that almost ended up in the back of the net with Malkin again.
Yes, James Neal sent.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. David Legwin got Malkin, and he got caught, or at least the
Malkin's
referee thinks so.
Down ice.
David Legwin's going to go. The question is, how much is he going to get?
He's gone for the game.
That's what I thought.
He's out.
Then he speared him. That's a five-minute penalty.
Detroit number 17. 5 minutes game is gone for butt-ending.
Oh, butt-ending. Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah.
He butt-ended him and right in the privates. Oh, boy. Yeah. Well.
He could be looking at more.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't escape cameras anymore in this day and age. And
yeah, not the best of time for Legwin to try to sneak that one in. Here we go.
So 4-4 and a five-minute power play for the Penguins. And they'll stay on it for the rest of this one. And if we get to extra time, it'll continue there too.
Well, that penalty is about as unwise as a Jokinen penalty earlier in the period.
If they get there. Neal goes wide with it. Just failing to get free there was Ferraro.
Oh, my goodness. You think that it's not a pressure cooker for Ferraro, the rookie out here in this situation? Oh, boy.
With Lashoff, Quincy, and Emerton. Simon Dupre turns inside the line. Kunitz, checked by Quincy. Played back here for Dupre. He's Jokinen. To Dupre, the shot. Howard came out. Niskanen. Rink wide, Jokinen. Checked. Good play, Emerton. Yeah.
Better hurry.
Ferraro hurry. Hurry to get a change. Back in they come. Neal to the middle. Howard the save. Wow. With two to go in the third. A bouncer held in by Olimata. Jokinen tried to go over and Miller blocked.
Boy, when you're shooting that puck with this out of play rule now, you got to cup your stick big time when you're shooting it from behind your net and banking it off the wall. You don't want that stick opened up to go over the boards.
Kunitz with Malkin and Crosby. Mata and Niskanen. Emerton and Ferraro. Kunitz through the seam. Dupre moved it. Crosby. Pass goes off a stick. Deflects to the corner. Some time here.
Oh boy.
But Ferraro unable to get it out. I think he was worried about another puck over the glass. Wanted to be sure, but it didn't go. Malkin in front. Another try. Kicked out. It couldn't get there. Whoa. Ferraro another try.
Quincy
again
stick.
Doesn't get it out though. Quincy moves over on Malkin, who escapes that. Goes to the front of the goal. Puck's loose. And jammed on behind the net. Half minute to go here in the third period. Ferraro with it again. Just wants to squeeze it.
Vlashov's without a stick. We don't know if it's broke or not. This is nuts.
Well, down a man without a stick. Quincy keeps it in the position to maybe block in front. Crosby missed that. He's got it again though. Vlashov trying to block that. Niskanen. Shot it blocked.
Wow. There's
big
a point.
Block there by Emerton. 3 seconds left. Passed in front of the goal. Crosby knocked down. Red Wings get a point.
What a nice
they
play.
Get a point. They're going to overtime. Still shorthanded, but they get a point.
Dan DeKeyser just showed you what a pro defenseman, an NHL defenseman, needs to do against the best player in the world. Final 3.5 minutes that was. Look at DeKeyser right here on Crosby. Stick on stick, Crosby goes down, no call made, clock runs out, Red Wings get a monumental point. And there's Quincy reaching out, or Malkin has got a wide open net, stare him in the face, and then Corey Emerton with that last block that pretty much killed the clock. Wow.
It's now a 2-2 game in that one.
You need to have a tight diamond for Detroit.
Malkin with a shot, saved by Howard. Malkin and Crosby and Kunitz and Neal. Glendening, the lone forward for Detroit. DeKeyser and Cronwall.
You almost have to leave them to the outside and not, you leave your post.
Malkin with a shot just wide.
In front of the net, and you're going to be in big time trouble with these guys who can move the puck precisely.
Shorthanded here, carry over of the David Leguan butt ending. Game misconduct penalty. Neal, stick in the lane, got a piece of that. Malkin. Neal to Malkin.
He wants
Neal
to shoot
again.
It.
Here's Neal shooting. Saved by Howard. Rebound, he's got it. With Kunitz right there at the doorstep.
Malkin kept giving it back to Neal like, James, will you shoot the dang thing? And he kept giving it back to Malkin. And now they're talking to each other about what they hopefully will do once they win this faceoff. That's what they're thinking. And somebody's called a timeout. I would think it's Pittsburgh by Mr. Bylsma, who's from Muskegon. Took the cup back there when they won it in 09.
And Jimmy Howard hearing the crowd.
Jimmy Howard.
Glendening and Crosby. Comes back to the line. Niskanen's got Malkin. Niskanen shooting. Off target there. Malkin's got it. Niskanen off his skate. Last shot down the block. Malkin in the lane. Glendening. Passed across. One too many. Back. Out of the box is Franzen. Red Wings at full strength. They've killed off that five-minute major.
Fleury.
Quincy moving up.
He might be cold, Fleury. Isn't that a shot?
Bronson, he's got Smith back in front. Nyquist. Oh, and just mishandled. But he still has it. Knocked away. Nyquist going to get it. Smith with a shot. In back of the net, Niskanen. For Brooks Orpik. Crosby to Malkin. Brendan Smith. Really pressured tonight. This crowd alive. Shane got it back for DeKeyser. Alfredson. He's got a goal tonight. Alfredson cut back. Can Kindle get over in time? Yes. First on it is Franzen. Cronwall in down low. Franzen gives him the puck at the half boards in front. Tip. Oh, and Alfredson just slapped it wide. Scuderi moved it around. Under two to go in overtime. Crosby bounces off Sheahan and brings it in. To Neal. To Crosby. Howard with the save. The big rebound. Neal nice got job. Back there to keep it in.
Nice job.
Neal circling up high. Less than a minute to go in overtime. And Howard making sure with Crosby there, there'd be no loose puck. Draw one by Pittsburgh. I may have skipped off the bar. I'm not sure if that didn't glance the crossbar.
It was a funny face-off, I know that.
DeKeyser up the right side, forced back, gave it away though. And Malkin's shot missed. Boy, Kunitz forced him and he turned it back when perhaps he shouldn't have. Less than a half minute to go in overtime. Nyquist.
What a night he's had. Holy smoke.
How many nights has he had? Amazing, but gave that one away to Malkin.
Three on two, four on two.
Four Penguins coming. Nyquist trying to get back. Kunitz gets some help off a stick. Now
look
Nyquist,
look at this.
Red Wings, only 5 seconds left though. Alfredson on the wing. He'll have to hurry. Alfredson shoots, save made, rebound. They score!
Oh boy.
They score!
Red Wings not on. We got it.
Red Wings may have won this game in overtime with no time. There was 0.4 seconds left, we believe.
Wow.
The Red Wings have won this game.
Four. No, they're telling everybody to stay put. We think our clocks tell us it's 0.4 seconds. The red light never came on, the blue light did, but it's not the first time that's happened.
Don't forget, the goal judges now are in the upper bowl. It's not so easy on reaction time. We believe, we'll get the clock in for you, we believe there was 0.4 seconds left when that puck crossed the line. We'll have it for you. Let's
there you
look.
Go. Take a look. Your clock is right here, gang.
Yes,
four
Red Wings win it.
Of a second, 3.5 to 0.4 left. This game is over unless the puck was kicked in. Let's see what happened. How did it get in? Oh, boy.
No distinct kicking motion, whatever.
Did it go off Sheahan or Franzen or whoever the heck was there? That's Nyquist, I mean, is there. What a night if he gets credit for this goal. Shot by Alfredson. What's it go off? Oh, my goodness. Are you kidding me? A third Penguin knocks it into their own net?
Off Scuderi.
I think it did. Second of the night off Scuderi. And another one off Matta. Oh,
this
my.
This is one huge win. Let's listen to make it official.
After review, there is time on the clock. It's a good goal.
Red Wings win it. Listen to this crowd. What a night. What a win for Detroit. 5-4.
Oh, my goodness. The whole team was standing over in front of the Red Wing bench waiting for this call. They didn't know. They did not know. Holy mackerel. Cardiac kids have done it again. Wow. It'll be Alfredson's goal, we think. And that, for sure, We'll be having another cold one on that baby. Brought to you by Miller Lite. We think it went off Scuderi, and it has been a rough night for the Penguins. Three goals have gone in off their defenseman, our Miller Lite play of the game. Alfredson, I think, will get credit for it. His second of the night. And oh, my goodness.
Consecutive game-winning goals for Daniel Alfredson against Toronto and against Pittsburgh in the most improbable of fashion. Alfredson opened the scoring tonight, and he closed the scoring tonight.
You couldn't draw this dramatics up any better than that. 4-on-3 in overtime. Here's your stars.
Alfredson thought that was for the star. They haven't done the stars yet. They're just announcing his goal. So he can come out again. Attaboy, Daniel. It's worth
take a camp, a double take for sure.
It's an encore.
Star
an encore.
Three from Detroit, number 35, Jimmy Howard.
Oh, geez. What a game.
39 stops for Jimmy.
Star number two from Pittsburgh, Evgeny Malkin.
Do it again, Daniel. Do it again.
And star number one from Detroit, number 11, Daniel Alfredson.